How many grafts will I need? I am a male in my early 20s and live in Texas. I know I'm young, but I do not have a history of baldness on either my father or mother's side. I have a high hairline. I believe it's an NW3 my whole life. I'm looking to get a follicular unit extraction transplant this summer. My two questions are these. How many grafts, based on my pictures, do you think I will need? Secondly, I'm not looking to spend all of my money at once, but I was wondering if I could do it in two or maybe even three sessions. Best regards.
Thank you for your question. You're in your 20s and you've submitted some very good photos to help me assess the degree of your hair loss. You stated that you are planning to get FUE grafts. You want to know how many grafts you'll need. And I think that the questions that you're asking are all very reasonable. Now, I'm probably going to help you a lot by educating you about something that we're doing in our practice that's a little bit different than the usual answers that you would get from a hair restoration specialist. So let's first begin with defining what your situation is. You are dealing with, unfortunately, at a young age, with male pattern hair loss. Male pattern hair loss traditionally has been based on a genetic pattern such that at different decades of our lives, most men will have some type of male pattern hair loss. Now, it's kind of a rule of decades. In your 20s, 20% of your contemporaries will have hair loss. That means that 80% of your contemporaries have lots of hair. When you hit your 40s and 50s, it starts to even out. 50% have significant hair loss, 50% have mild or moderate, but to some degree, a lot of men by the fourth or fifth decade of life will have some degree of hair loss. In the 90s, specifically around 1997, when the drug Finasteride was introduced, we had an understanding of male pattern hair loss based on something called dihydrotestosterone, or DHT. And the concept is that at a certain point of your life, a protective mechanism turns off. And then dihydrotestosterone literally chokes the hair follicle and causes thinning. Many men mistakenly believe that they have too much testosterone. And although that is kind of wishful thinking, it's not true. Most men have normal testosterone, depending on whatever age range they're at. But it's the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. And the dihydrotestosterone is what causes the hair follicle to shrink. So a drug like finasteride diminishes the amount of DHT or dihydrotestosterone. Now, move the clock forward. And in 2011, research done in the University of Pennsylvania and Yale showed that there are certain stem cells, active adult stem cells, that are responsible for the hair growth process that suddenly stopped working. And they noticed that in the scalps of bald men, the hair follicles were present, but the hair did not continue to grow. So essentially, we're dealing with inactive follicles. In our practice, in the past 2 years, we have had the remarkable opportunity to develop an injection using a wound healing model to stimulate and reverse thinning hair. So let me explain that further. If you would imagine that these adult stem cells are responsible for the protection of the hair follicle from DHT or dihydrotestosterone, then imagine that we apply a material that causes healing in a cellular level that protects the hair follicle. We'll refer to this as progenitor cells, as was referred to in the University of Pennsylvania study. These progenitor cells, think of it as protecting the hair follicle. So essentially, what we've been able to do is literally create a wall in a conceptual way, because this has to be proven from laboratory studies. But conceptually, this is what appears to be the case. And so by doing this, thinning hair is being reversed in our practice with this injection. And this is a very important point, particularly for somebody who's in their 20s. When you're in your 20s, and you can imagine by the time in your 30s, 40s, your hair loss would otherwise progress. And even if you take a DHT blocker like finasteride, you can still progress. So traditionally in hair transplant, we were always hesitant to perform transplant on a 20-year-old because, or someone in their 20s, because they can continuously lose their hair while the transplanted hair, the genetically resistant hair, would stay. And it would force them to have to keep doing more and more. So my suggestion for you is to actually consider this kind of hair regeneration technology. And if in our practice, just to give you a perspective of what we do, when we use our hair regenerative technology, we'll do that first. We'll do the injection first. Then after a year and what when we see how much regrowth you have, we then decide if you want more hair, we can then do a transplant. And even with a transplant, we're using this regenerative healing technology that allows our donor area to heal beautifully and for our hair grafts to take very well. So to answer your question about the number of grafts, that's very straightforward. The number of grafts is dependent on the area that you want to cover. And typically, the hair transplant zones are frontal, middle, and back. And generally, in a given transplant, we will transplant anywhere from 1,500 to 2,000 hairs. And we'll do that usually towards the front, because the hair frames the face. And if you want to frame the face, you want to do it towards the front. Now, that may not be adequate to cover as much as you desire, and that's where additional transplantation may be recommended. But in summary, I think before you consider a transplant, think about investigating both the dihydrotestosterone DHT blocker, although currently finasteride, there's a lot of controversy about long-term side effects. And in addition, consider this new hair regenerative technology that we have been in the forefront of, and then consider a transplant. So I know that was a lot to learn, but I hope that was helpful. Thank you for your question.